Wow, the mind game song is so interesting. The DAO will never forget. Somebody is going to write a story about that. Mr. DJ, put it up for us. From there, after the dance from my interpreters. So can you request for the best song you want? Can you request for the best song you want? Can I choose for you? Can we choose for them the song? I'm waiting for you to choose the song.
I want that song to
let you go. Will it let you go,
my friend? By yourself. By yourself. Will it let you go, my friend? So. Will it let you go, my friend? Mr. DJ, where are you? The DJ is coming, and I want to tell you that people online, I want to hear someone saying that we are there. People online, are you there? All right. Unfortunately, they did amplify for us the people online. We would be hearing them. Can I hear people online? Namre the process, are you there with us? Richard, I can see you. Chantel, Atpaye, are you with us? Thanks for being there. I can see the messages are flowing and believe they are enjoying. So it's jumping, and I wasn't telling you that you know online. I wanted to hear someone saying that we are wow. They are there online following us. Thank you so much, Mr. DJ. Okay, my interpreters, I don't know why you delayed someone to operate for us the machine. I'm going to choose for you any soul of my choice. My interpreters, I can't forget that you have to dance for us. Guru, at this moment you not. But I want you to tell us each one. In 3 seconds, you tell us who you are. Just tell us who you are in 3 seconds. The floor is you.
Happy to see you.
Good morning, all. I'm so happy to see you. My name is Emma Michael. Yes, I'm a sign language interpreter. And I'm also a student at Chambogo University. That's all about me. Thank you.
Good morning, all. My name is Hope.
Nyamwiza.
That's a sign name. She's a sign language interpreter, an advocate for deaf in Masaka City.
Deaf girls in
Masaka City. Thank you so much.
And I am a student soon.
And she's becoming a student soon. Thank you. Wow. Thank you so much. And we have a question. Let me ask the group. Thank you for the opportunity. I'd like to ask something small. I'd like to know more about you. Are you single or married? Are you looking for something? Yeah, I explained that question. And contented. I think the answer is gotten. And let's go direct to the business now. My dear proposers and opposers, allow me ask one of the judges to give us the rules that we shall be following during our disagreement in order to agree. Please allow me to ask one of them. I am a very passionate teacher of English language and literature in English. Oh, good, interesting. Yes, I'm very privileged to be here. And we are representing National Debate Council Uganda. I serve as the programs manager at National Debate Council Uganda. And we largely deal with young people in the areas of debate, speech, poetry, and all acts to make sure that young people find a voice to talk about issues that affect them, but to express themselves freely, but use that as a vehicle to spread that gospel that they think is most appropriate for them. So to us, we think that it's most appropriate that if you have the ability, that is not enough. You need spaces like Science for All debate to help you come and communicate and air out, share and exchange your opinion and what you think with the rest of the surrounding. And at this point, I want to thank Science for All. It's a very interesting initiative. When we heard about it through our very own Susan, we didn't take a second, we didn't debate. We have been fighting for this, and we really wanted it to happen, even when it came on a short notice. So that maybe we'll communicate later, but for now I can only do two things. To introduce the rest of the team I have come with, but also share a few guidelines with our very spark, beautiful and handsome debaters that are going to put up a very heated debate. To me, I think today will mark one of my best days of this year. I have never been to such an occasion. It's the very first time. While I have maybe interacted with other communities with disabilities, I have never interacted with a community of the deaf. And to me, it's an honor, but most of all, it's an opportunity for us to learn. So that when we go back, like someone said, we preach the gospel. That we need each other. And if you are at peace, I am at peace. If you are not at peace, I am not, in real sense, at peace. Thank you. Now, along with me, I've come with a lady and a gentleman, very young, but from the things they do, all their heart and hearts are here. And when they heard of this opportunity to represent NDC here, at the very first one, they're like, okay, even if it means walking, we'll all be there. So I'll request a lady and a gentleman so that we know them. And then the rest of the things maybe will come later after the debate, but not to take a lot of time. I'll start with the gentleman and then we'll move to the lady. Yes.
A very good morning, everyone. A very good morning, everyone. My name is Festo Kato. I'm a born and raised of Kasese. But I'm a resident in Masaka. I work as a communications officer or community manager for National Debate Council. I've been a debater since 2016. I'm glad to be here, and I'm glad to see everyone smiling, and I hope this is going to mark the very best of days from today's forth. I hope to see more faces of your kind at the other tournaments that we have around the country, and I hope to see more events of the same kind coming up after this one. Thank you very much.
A very good morning to everyone. My name is Nismita Skavia. I'm a student at the Ambassador of Law for my point here, and I'm very happy to be here. I'm a debater since 2017. I'm also a big judge, so in case you find me there, I don't think I'm aware. But also, I am an advocate of equality, and this was a very good thing when I heard about it. I was like, wow, I think I've not had any tournament that includes this category, everyone gets to the other people and they forget about the Israelites. And yet they also have the voices to raise and the other issues that people need to hear about. So I'm very happy to be here, and I think this is going to be one of the best moments that I can say in debate, seeing people of the Negev come up, you know, use the sign language. Yeah, it's really interesting. Yeah. Yeah, thank you very much.
And someone just showed me that they are excited. This side is not excited. Okay. Team proposition. Where is team proposition? Are you winning the debate? Yes? You ready? Okay. This is team proposition.
These are proposers.
Oh, these are proposers. These are opposers. Okay. So, you're ready? You're going to win the debate? They are convicted. That they are going to sweep them off. Team opposition. Are you ready for that, bro? Okay. So, just to start off, at National Debate Council, maybe our role in this engagement is that one, it's the very first time it is happening, and we're very proud that we are part of the journey that has commenced today. It is going to be memorable that, you know, at all times we are part of an initiative, and this has been an idea from heads of individuals who God, you know, has, you know, given a vision. And we do not know what God spoke to Alex the time he was thinking about this initiative. And then the 50 people that we have had that are so far part of this program. And then the many millions and thousands of lives that this project is going to touch. So for us as National Debate Council, we find relevance in communication. And in the pit, someone who was speaking here, the gentleman there was talking about being inclusive in community. Where do we find the voice? We thought it important that while debate offers so much speaking opportunities by word of mouth, we felt we were a little bit limited. Some other communities were not being catered for, especially people living with disabilities. But we are happy to report that for over time, since 2009, when we've been doing debates with students in schools, we have also had a singular opportunity, unlike other entities, to have students with disabilities, especially the blind. How many of us know Iganga SS? Hey, we have an OG here. All right, that's good to know. At the National Schools Debate Championship, we've had Iganga excellently do well, and for a record, we've had 3 years at the National Championship where the blind have topped and been awarded as best speakers. One of them is Lyombo Abbas. I think he's a student of law at Makerere University. And then I think he won it twice. He has had an opportunity to represent Uganda at international tournaments. And then the other one is Tumisime, who was also from Iganga. So we are looking at that as an opportunity that even when you're blind, you go, do research, come. What matters is the idea. How about those that cannot listen? So we stretched our wings, and from 2021 we started arts that include poetry, fine arts, music or song. We also do essay writing. We also look at other ideas like interview, just to make sure that someone finds space where they can share their ideas and pass the message across. So that is what we are, and that is what we continue pushing for. I have looked at the poem written by Sarah, yes, Christy, and I was very amused. with a great sense of humor that came from Isaac, you can't just imagine. With the storytellers, those stories, we teach them in literature, and students really, you know, take time to pick them. But with sign language, someone told this story here, and I felt the power of storytelling. I was like, yes, I wish I could also do like he's doing. So to us, we think that this partnership that has just begun is not dying today, and we pray and pledge that it will continue, and we shall continue to avail other opportunities, especially to those of us that are very interested in learning and participating. For now, let me just share a few guidelines for the debaters. The motion is very clear. Adopting this house believes that adopting technology is the only way to improve education of the deaf learners. As a teacher, I also run a mentorship hub, and I've had one this experience. I am an edtech enthusiast who looks at, you know, how best we integrate technology into teaching and learning. And I have had one experience during the COVID-19 lockdown when I started this mentorship hub. It has lots of students from different backgrounds. So there is this one boy who used to be so active on WhatsApp. You send messages, you see his comments, and they're like, this is brilliant. You bring a topic of discussion in group, and you see him very well. He participates and is interested. Now, I didn't know that this boy had issues with hearing. And time went on, I established a Google Classroom to help them do their writing, debate, and the rest of the activities. So as time went on, I sent a voice note in group, and then I see him put question marks. So reaching to a friend who had recommended this boy, I'd be like, but what's wrong with Joel? I see others maybe trying to do voice notes. He never, when we do video calls, he does typing. So I got concerned. And then Paul told me, you know, Joel has issues with hearing. So I was very touched, and I felt that if maybe it wasn't for WhatsApp or Google Classroom, why this boy would come and do assignments, very time conscious. You set an assignment, and he's always among the first people to submit. You look at his poems or his essays, and you're like, God. But when it comes to live sessions or speaking, he would not contribute. After finding out that, I really felt that there is a lot that is needed to make sure people have the space to express themselves. And I wondered if it wasn't maybe for technology, using WhatsApp, Google Classroom, how best did I know that there is a Joel who is very gifted and he has a lot of power in writing? So to me, I think at a personal level, I feel it's very important. And two, because I'm a teacher, I always want to make sure that every learner and their need is met. And that's why we have this space. So for our speakers, debate is not war. Debate is not war. Debate is only a vehicle. As the MC once said, we agree to disagree. We cannot say, no, totally, me, I disagree. A manner is not important. How many of us have debated manner is better than valor? Water is better than fire. And then teacher and doctor. A village and town. So you would see a villager typically arguing. Okay? But town life is far much better than village life when they have never lived in the town. Okay? So, but that is just a thought. You're sharing your ideas. Not because I am not deaf, will I dispute that?